Yeah, 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 you already know what it is. The team president, Mr. MySpace, Sean Kingston, here himself out in stores right now. They watching the 24-hour podcast. Go get that out, man. You know what it is.
T-minus 4, 3, 2, 1.
The following is a 24-hour podcast.
Your way to view.
It's become the soundtrack of the summer, Sean Kingston. You can't go anywhere without hearing the name Sean Kingston. You can't turn on any radio without hearing Sean Kingston. How do you feel when you're driving around, you just put on a radio and you hear yourself?
Man, I feel good, man. Like, I feel really excited. I mean, I feel blessed. You know what I'm saying? It's something that I always wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? Just me being here making great music. It's just like, wow, you know what I'm saying? Like, I always wanted to just tap in and, you know, talk to my fans. And, you know what I mean? Just have everybody respect. You know what I'm saying, what I'm doing, and you know what I'm saying, I'm getting a lot of love, so I'm loving it.
Was it something that you actually designed? Because I know that you hooked up with your producer through MySpace, and you just basically wanted him to hear your tunes. Did you ever think that you would have this much success this early on?
Yeah, you know what I mean, I never did, you know what I'm saying, but what got me here is persistence and hard work, so I'm saying it is what it is.
Now you've hooked up some pretty good hooks on the CD. You've got a bit of Benny King, Stand By Me. You've got Phil Collins. You've got some Led Zeppelin. What were your personal musical influences growing up?
Oh man, Stevie Wonder, Bob Marley, Luther Vandross, Tupac, Biggie, Lauryn Hill, the Fugees, Jay-Z. Just everybody that was good at what they do. You know what I'm saying?
Let's talk about hooking up with J.R. Rotem as the producer. Now, pretty accomplished guy, done a lot of really good stuff. What did he tend to mold you a little bit? What did he bring out in Sean Kingston?
I was like a diamond, but I was also missing some stuff, you know what I'm saying? And when I met up with J.R., he polished me, got me right, you know what I mean? Had me meet up with other people, and he basically developed me into Sean Kingston today, so.
Have you had any feedback from any of the artists that you've been sampling on there?
Yeah, man, everybody loves my music, man. Yeah. They loving every track on the Sean Kingston album stores right now. We'll get you a copy of the album, you know what I'm saying? It's incredible. It's a classic album. You gotta go get it, you will not go wrong. I don't like to buy albums today myself, but if I hear some tracks and I like it, I will support the artist. And, you know what I'm saying, if I were Sean Kingston and I heard, you know, tracks like Beautiful Girls and tracks like Me Love, I would go out and buy this album. So I think, you know, it's only right for you guys to buy the album. It's a great album, 14 tracks, you know what I'm saying? It's
good, cool. Bargain price. Did you have a lot of fun shooting the videos?
Oh, yeah, it was a lot of fun, exciting. I'm saying, Beautiful Girls was, you know, felt like I was in middle school again, you know, that was so fun. Me Love video is pretty cool, too, you know what I'm saying? That's coming out in 2 weeks, so I look out for that. So it was a good look.
Because you're so young, Sean, I mean, all of a sudden your friends must be making more notice of you. What's it been like since you've become this big star?
Oh, man, you know what I'm saying? I can't, you know, people just starting to recognize me more and more. And people's recognizing my work, and they're recognizing different stuff that I'm doing. But it's been cool, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, people's loving me, man. Like, you know, they're just like, wow, this kid blew up. You know what I'm saying? Like, this kid worked. But you know what kind of makes it more interesting? That I always, you know, people know me as a rapper. People knew me as a singer in my school. So they weren't shocked, and it's not shocked to see me blown up. It's just like, wow, I went to school with that kid. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
What may be shocking to some people, though, is that it's clean. The lyrics are totally clean. And was that a conscious effort you made on your part to make it clean?
Yes, sir. No profanity in the music. No profanity in the music. I think that's a good look. So all my singers out there, all my, you know, my upcoming artists out there, I can't put no profanity in my music. No profanity is the best way to go. You know what I'm saying? I think a lot of, I'm a role model to the kids. I think a lot of people appreciate me. And I have a lot of fans out there due to the fact that there's no profanity in my music.
Let's talk about the track Dry Your Eyes. Very personal, very powerful track. Sort of tells your story. Was it hard for you to put the words together to that one?
Not really, you know what I'm saying? Dry Your Eyes, the words just proved to that song due to the fact I've been through a lot of situations with my mom. My mom played both sides, you know what I mean? She played my mom and she played my dad. So like, I had no problems writing that song because everything just flew to me because everything is real in that song, 100% real. And my mom's locked up right now. She's incarcerated, but that song is, you know, just letting her know to hold her head down, you know what I'm saying? Everything's going to be all right. Stop crying. I got you, you know what I'm saying? So it's a good song.
Your mom must be extremely proud of you.
She is, man. She loves everything that I got going right now.
You're traveling around. Did you get a chance much to see anything of the city, or are you just in and out so fast?
In and out so fast, but you know, I'm going to be in Canada for a couple days, so it's going to be fun.
Well, Vancouver says welcome. Thank you, Sean Kingston.
No problem, man. Thanks for having me, man.
24hours.ca